Hey everyone, this is Mihash and today is the episode number 14. Today our day started very late, you can say, because if you don't know, I'll like link up the vlog. You'll get to know. I also do a side business, not side business, but I work for into my family business also. So my 4 to 5 hours of my starting day, which is like from 5 to sometimes 10 or from 6 to 9, 10 goes there. So today my day literally started from 12, now it's 2. Like I had a call with a client, not my right now client, but I had previously worked, you can say it as ex-client. She's like completely lost the hope from getting any businesses with social media, because first she was getting some social attention, brand awareness, but right now she's also She's saying that she isn't getting time on to focus on the passion, or you can say side business. So right now she's working on in a company, different company, but she didn't have the time to work. So did work for 3 to 4 months and completely lost it. Even if you go into the website, there is not even a single post on Instagram. One post in 2 or 3 days, zero Instagram stories. So obviously I said that even if you are not good at video, just post or write. They don't want to do anything. That might be the reason they are right now out of the business. Obviously, if you're not marketing digitally, if you're not communicating digitally in today's world, your brand or your business will be dead. Because right now each and every business is trying to get online, whether it's service business, product business, or referral business also. So today, like, just having my lunch. After my lunch I have to think of a, because right now it also 2 to 3 days gap and lectures is also going on. So plan my day about what I'm going to do about my podcast. Yes, I have written articles. I've also I'm working on my blog post, but blog is not able to get daily or quickly or consistently as it should be, because daily vlog is what my plan to be, but it gets really very hard to shoot in this environment. And also, yes, so I am complaining because of the shooting thing, but I'm not really complaining. So I'm writing in the free time. So that's the thing. And also not doing separate podcast, as I said that I will be doing separate podcast also, but it sounds good and it sounds easy to have podcast, to have all the with social media, which is like Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube, a vlog thing, podcast thing, article. It sounds easy, but it really isn't. So you only get to know about the things when you actually do things. So right now I'm just chopping up the questions which I answer on blog, converting it into a MP3 and posting it into my podcast. Guys, here's the only thing I would like to say to the brand or the business or the personal brand who is right now starting. Even I am right now starting, and the only way to stand out from others, I'm not sure whether I'm the right person to share this or not, but I'm actually doing this right now. That's why I'm saying it right now. Yes, although I'm not that big and I've not got as much result as should be, but I don't expect it, and I just take advice from the ones who have already done it, and I'm just right now focusing on me. When it comes to content and like standing out from others, if you're like a bakery business and like a beauty business or whatever products or service you are selling it right now, they are right now going into marketing agencies. That's a good thing you are doing it, because if you are right now not marketing it online, obviously you may be right out of business. There are businesses who are right now also working well in offline physical thing, but what I think is online is like going in. This is my prediction, and the data shows that each and every business is trying to get online. So if you have to be on, if you are online, and then obviously you have to market it online. To market online, you have to, like, you have two steps, like two steps or two ways to market online, whether you are paid media or you could own media, which is like you or earn media, where like in paid media, obviously you are going to run ads, you are going to spend some money, that's okay. And you have to, at some point, you have to spend some money online also, in ads or influencer marketing, or whether it's like paid promotion thing, you have to do it. When you have a business, I'm talking about the business perspective, and the own or earn media is into which you create content about, is like about, okay, about the things which you like, about the thing which you are trying to make it, about the thing which you want it, you are trying to sell, about like all other things which you like, you could easily create content online, and there is no one between you and me to stop this, right? Like it's just like shooting it and posting it online, whether it's like LinkedIn, Instagram, YouTube, on my blog. So, and specifically doing this because it will, I'm also going to put this on a podcast. So, hey podcast, if you're not subscribed to my podcast, Harsh Dhav, on Spotify, Google Podcast, and let's, I'm getting off the topic, all right. So, when it comes about standing up from the crowd, there are hundreds of thousands, millions of creators posting about in your niche. I'm talking about the globally. So, the people usually search online, they ask about like the agency in which they're working with, how do we stand out, like what are the hack, or what are the, you can say, the strategy to come out. There are a lot of fake gurus also, they say that use these hashtags and do that. I respect them also. What from my perspective is I want to share with you from like what I've also given to my clients. I have only worked with 3 to 4 clients, and what I have said to them, obviously none of them listen to me, and they're right now out of business. Not all, but one. I actually said in this vlog, right? Why not like just start a vlog channel, or like just document whatever you are doing? Is like when you're, if you're from my perspective, I'm trying to build my own personal brand, whether it's like marketing thing. I like doing marketing. I also like playing games, but right now I'm not completely into that. I like it, but only for half an hour, 1 hour, 2 hours, not more than that. So I'm not good at it. And also I don't love it as much as I will able to put in those hours, but I really like it. And that's why I'm putting in hours. Like if you watch a specific vlog, there's a lot hard work around that, like documenting, like pulling some clips onto this, editing, and then uploading it. This is not only that. I also do post-production, which is like chop the clips on Instagram, LinkedIn, Facebook, and sometimes I also use as an article. And this is the clip which I'm sure I will use on podcast, LinkedIn, Instagram. I'll do it. Why? Because it feels authentic, it connects with people. And there are also the brands which are, they have zero subscribers and they are spending like $2,000 on camera, lighting. I respect that also. It is, you can say it is helpful, but not in starting. Like I started a vlog, I took the advice from Gary and just documenting it. Even though I'm not getting any subscribers, like it should, when from a specific video, if I'm like, hey, and this video we are going to talk this, and that's over, I can do that. But I'm not doing it because I want to play the long term game, and that's why I'm documenting it, chopping it the clips, and that's helping me standing out from others. Very less people are doing this right now, documenting thing, but very a lot of people who are like trying to play a short term game, obviously they are only gonna last for a short time. So just like document it. Obviously you'll get a lot of content. Podcast audio is also going to win. It is right now also winning. So the data is right now showing you that just documenting, creating content which feels authentic and which resonates with your consumer is going to win. As I was working on my website SEO, one thing which like my website, I use a cheap hosting, which is like $20 hosting per year.
So what I got to learn from that is they actually don't have a good hosting plan. So don't use that unless you don't have a good money, like at least to spend on a good hosting. I wasn't having it, that's why I spent on that. To I will like I thought that I'll manage it, and right now I'm only managing it. So I was working on my technical SEO. As you know that your website speed matters a lot because it shows your consumer experience wherever a consumer or your new visitor clicks on a link and it's not opening it, whether it's like a mobile thing. Visitors on mobile are like increased a lot because your website technical SEO can be easily compare like you can say that maintained well on desktop thing, but it is not as easy as on mobile. Yes, right now there's a lot of plugins, which is AMP thing, and I recommend you to use that also if you have a lot of content then only. But yes, if the keyword is like very easy to rank and you have built links, you have good post, and then also you are not ranking, then you should really look into that AMP thing. But as I'm speaking on the website SEO, which is like your website speed matters a lot, and my website speed was around 40. Yes, of I measured it on a Google, which is like Google page speed tool. I measured on that. First it was 40, and I use a plugin which is a famous plugin, and I'm sure that you will be knowing about this. If you don't know about it, its name is W3 Total Cache. Cache or Cache, I don't know about that. How do you pronounce that? But I really recommend you to use that because it has a lot of caching thing. Because whenever, for example, if I'm a returning visitor of your website, and first time it takes like around 5 seconds to load a website, which is not good. Like 2 to 3 seconds is good. So my website took, for example, I'm saying 5 seconds, and once again when I'm returning, it will only take 1 to 2 seconds to load a website. That's a good thing, and it also has a lot of CDN thing, which is Cloudflare. You can use free CDN Cloudflare. Also, it gives you SSL, HTTPS SSL, and it is good for your website security also. And I had read into a blog post where Google gives priority to HTTPS, and it really gives more searches to if your website have it is secured. It's good for you. Like when do thing, it's like just connect to Cloudflare and that's it. You will get a good priority from Google also. So always like SSL certificate is always mandatory right now, because what W3 Total Cache do is it optimizes your website for user experience. It helps you in like HTML font, and there's a lot of technical things which I don't know, and I don't like even to talk about that because I don't know HTML, JavaScript, and yes, it also optimizes or compresses your image size and load lazy, which is when a user scrolls down, then only the image will load. That will save you a lot of time in loading the page. There's a lot of like nowadays there are a lot of good plugins and bad plugins also. Bad plugins in the sense that they will make your website very heavier than so that it will take very more time to load a website, and this will increase your bounce rate too. I recommend you to like if you want some before after. I thought that I have taken a screenshot, so here's a before image and here's after image. It really helps, and if the screenshot doesn't appear, I'm sorry for that. I actually had posted on story that it is working, and like it is not bad to promote good products. So like it wasn't a promotion, but it is good, and I recommend you to use also because it will help you.
Instagram, here's how you can get some clients on Instagram by just searching. You just have to go to hashtags, search for your keyword, which is for my example, small business owners. Search for the latest post, DM them how you can bring them value, and just do every day 100 to 200 people, out of which you'll get 5 to 10, and from 5 to 10, at least one or two may convert. Two is always better than not doing anything.